So the holidays are finally upon us, and I thought I would put together a last minute gift guide for camera accessories, filmmaking gear under $50. Keep in mind, some of this stuff is on sale, so you gotta act quick because, again, right now, everything that I'm featuring is under $50. Let's go ahead and kick things off with the very first item, which is the Aputure Gobo Kit. This is a 10-piece kit. Now, if you're not familiar with what a gobo is, basically it's a little piece of aluminum that has a cutout that allows you to create really unique backgrounds like what you see back here. Now, the way it works is if you have, like, for example, an Aputure 120D, a 300D, you need to get their little spotlight mount, but you can buy this whole kit. It's a 10-piece kit, because we're using one right now, and you can get it for under $50. In fact, this one's kind of cool. Let me show you one of my favorite ones. This one emulates like a window. In fact, let's go ahead and put this one on right now so you guys can see what that looks like. Okay guys, so what do you think of this one? This is the arch window pattern, and this is the one that we actually had in there before, which kind of has a tech vibe to it. Here's another one, looks like a jail cell. Kind of cool if you're going for that vibe. And then we have another one here. I really like this one. In fact, we used this one in our last video. So if you want to check that out, there'll be a link down below. And then here's another one that looks like a firework. In fact, we've never used this one. Connor, do you mind putting this one on there so we can check it out? Okay, I think that looks pretty fun. So what's cool about these two, and if you're familiar with the spotlight, is that you can get it in focus and out of focus to really kind of spice up the design. So for example, right now, Connor, if you want to put it into focus, so he's up there kind of messing with the light, that looks cool, then we'll get it out of focus. So that's the idea, is that you can basically take any of these designs, make it look a little bit more blurred out, and for $50, I mean, these are kind of a no-brainer. So the next item I want to talk about is these Condor Blue body caps. They are beautiful, made out of aerospace grade aluminum. So they're very high quality, and something that I really like about them is that they are locking. What I mean by that is, like your traditional body caps, they're made out of plastic and normally you can just take them off. But watch this. When I take this off and then I put the Condor Blue body cap, hear this. It locks into place. So I physically need to hit the release button to take it off. And this is gonna be great because it's going to protect the sensor. Another thing that I like about this, and you can see here, are these little grooves, and they make it easier to remove and obviously put on. Again, really high quality material, and they also come in different types of mounts. So we have one here for the Fuji X-T4, or the X mount, of course, which looks great. And then I have one over here for my Canon EF mount. And another thing I like about these is if you're on set, like, you know this is your body cap. You don't have those little cheap plastic ones. Normally they're about $40. I think it's a great buy, like jewelry for your camera. So the next product I want to talk about is the Watson Rapid Charger. Now this is going to recharge your rechargeable batteries. And what I like about this one in particular is that it'll accept AA batteries, but also AAA batteries in the same spot. So you notice how I put this AA battery here. Watch this. I'll take this AA out and then I'll put this AAA battery inside here and it'll work. Another thing I like about it is that it shows you on the LCD display how much battery life it has and or how long it's going to charge. And something else, which is kind of neat, is that they also include a car charger, which is great if you're on the road. Now this whole entire kit, excluding the batteries, will run you $40, assuming you already have rechargeable batteries. But yeah, I think it's a great buy. And honestly, you know, for me, I use it with my MixPre 6 a lot. So I like traveling with this, and they charge the batteries really fast. So for this next item I want to talk about is this hot shoe level. So you place this on the hot shoe of your camera, like you see here on the X-T4. And the great thing about this is that, for example, if you're using a camera that doesn't show you a horizon level, you can just use this. Or even a camera like the X-T4 that actually does have that, you don't have to go into the menu system. You can just at a glance see if you're perfectly level. These are $4 for $8, so they're fairly inexpensive. So if you have four cameras, you can just throw them on there. They're great. I mean, stocking stuffers, highly recommend these. Now the next item I want to talk about is the Polar Pearl Defender lens cover. These things are great. They run $25, and I'm telling you, once you get these, like, you cannot go back. I use them for all of my lenses. This is my vintage lens kit. And what I like about them is I typically get 82mm, like the larger size, because I have gears and they literally fit all of my lenses. So I'll show you. These are my, again, these are my vintage lenses. Carl Zeiss, I know, minor flex there. Okay, now I'm gonna show you. I have another lens. This is a Fujifilm lens. It's a 58 millimeter. And because I always put lens filters in front of my lenses, I typically always go to 82. So even with an 82 step-up ring, if I grab one of these Defender lens covers, boom, look at that. And the best part about it is that it protects your lenses. Like, it's really tough material that they use. It's like a rubber material, as opposed to like the typical plastic ones that you see in traditional, you know, lenses. I'll show you something else that I like about them too. So I have my 24 to 70. Like I said, I always use, you know, filtration in the front. And even with a lens filter, I can still put this on. This is an 82 millimeter. And then look at that, no problem. As opposed to, I'm using the Canon one over here. It typically falls off. It doesn't really snap into place. I mean, this is what I don't like about it. If it's in your bag and then there it goes, it bounces around, it hits something, it's just gonna come off. I don't trust these. For $25, see, I don't even like these. For $25, highly recommend these. I like them. Again, they're gonna protect your glass. Your glass is your investment, definitely worth buying. So the next products I wanna talk about is the Moment CineBloom diffusion filters. These things are great. In fact, we've been using one in this whole video on our A-cam. That is the 10%. They come in two variations. You have the 10% and over here is the 20%. I gotta say, the packaging is really nice. Take a look at that. That is beautiful. They did a really good job on the packaging. I love the red outer trim. Really easy to screw on because it has these grips here, which I like. But what I like about these is that it gives your footage a film-like look. For example, like the shadows get lifted up a bit. It has that faded film. Also, the highlights has this like halation look to it. It looks beautiful. Like I said, they have a 10% version, which is the one we're using, and a 20%. 20% I recommend using during nighttime, and then obviously the 10% for me personally, I like it more like daytime use or typical A-roll shots as you see here. Pricing is going to depend on the type of filter that you need. So for example, like the 67 millimeter version is obviously gonna be more inexpensive compared to the 82. Right now they're having a sale, prices keep fluctuating, but normally the starting price is $50. However, I highly recommend, I always go with the higher one, 82 millimeter. Even if you have a 72 millimeter lens, use a step up ring because just in case you ever buy an 82 millimeter lens, at least you're future proof. Anyway, I think they look very beautiful. And if you consider what the competition goes for something similar to this, I think they're a great buy. So the next product I wanna talk about is the Viltrox L11-6T. I've talked about this particular light several years ago, but I think it's still worth mentioning because I think it's a fantastic light. You can pick it up for $36 without the battery, or you can pick it up for $45 with the battery. What I like about this light is, first of all, it is pretty bright. So this is at 20% right now, and I'm gonna go ahead and raise it up to 100% just to show you how bright this light gets. Give me a minute. Here it goes, and that's 100%. I mean, that's pretty bright. Another thing that I like about it is that it's also bicolor, and it has this really cool LCD display on the back. So let me just bring the intensity down a bit, and then I'll show you the bicolor. So right now, we're at daylight, 5600 Kelvin, and I'm gonna go ahead and bring it down all the way to 3300 Kelvin. So now we have this nice warm light. Very soft, which is beautiful. Yeah, I mean, there's not much more to say except that this light is awesome and you can also power it via a DC adapter. Definitely worth having this in your bag. So for this next product I wanna talk about is the Polar Pro memory card case. The outer shell is made out of aluminum, and then on the inside, this has a rubber material, which is great for shock absorption. So if it gets tossed around in your bag, you know that your memory cards are going to be safe. They come in different variations. So depending on the type of memory card that you use the most, you can buy the appropriate one. I have two of them here. This one here is for micro SD and also SD card. The one over here is for micro SD, SD card, and CF Express or XQD. And what I like about it is that it has a layered system. So for example, I have a CF Express card here, and then if I take this out, it reveals an SD card. And then if I take this out, it has two slots for micro SD, which I really dig this layered system. Now, if you're looking for the ultimate storage, definitely pick up the SD card version because this one here holds 24 cards, which has a total of 16 micro SD cards and then a total of 8 SD cards. These are great. They are $40 and are a great way to protect your footage. So for this next item, we have these little guys here. They are called the Sprig Cable Management Anchors. And the way they work is they have these little rivets that attach to a 1/4-20 mount on a cage. Let me demonstrate. I have a cage over here, and all you need to do is pick any of these 1/4-20 mount holes, and all you do is just pop it in there. You can give it a little twist to kind of lock it in there, and now you basically have a great cable management system. So in this particular setup, we're imagining there's a camera here with a follow focus, and then all I want to do is make sure that my cables are nice and tidy. So all I have to do is just pop them in there, pop this one in over here. There we go, and I'll bring this up to the top cam so you can kind of see that. I like them. I mean, they do feel a little bit disposable, but for 18 bucks, they get the job done. This next product that I want to talk about is the Condor Blue Coiled Braided HDMI cable, which comes in different variants. You have the micro, the mini, and the full size HDMI. These things are just very heavy duty. I really like them a lot, but the best part about these is that this will be the last HDMI cable that you will ever buy. And the reason I say this is because they have a lifetime warranty. So if they fail for any reason, they will replace these at no additional cost. In fact, they will even ship them to you for free, which is actually pretty amazing. So if you picked up a Sony A7S and you're rocking an Atomos Ninja recorder, these are actually going to be perfect for those type of setups. In fact, they run $20, considering high quality cables cost like 50 and above. This is actually a steal. So those were some of my favorite top 10 filmmaking accessories under 50 bucks that I thought would be really good for the holidays. I will leave some honorable mentions linked down below if you guys are interested in looking at that list. My name is Armando Ferreira. Thanks again for watching, and you will catch me in the next one. Adios.